May I present you tonight with a marvelous explanation of the triune God in classical Arabic in the Quranic style with English interpretation. بسم الآب الكلمة الروح الإله الواحد الأوحد يا أيها الذين أشركوا من عبادنا أدعونا أو أدعوا الرحمن أو عدوا الرحيم أيما تدعوننا فلنا التجليات الحسنى جميعا مثلثة موحدة فردا وترا فأنا تشركون. In the name of the Father, the Word, the Holy Spirit, the one and only true God. O you of our worshippers who have gone astray and have added partners to us, call upon us or call upon the merciful one or yet call upon the most beneficent. By whatever name you may call us, unto us are the excellent names which are triune in unity, united in Trinity. So why would you become apostates and not believe this declaration? فَمَا اتَّخَذْنَا وَلَدًا وَمَا كَانَتْ لَنَا صَاحِبَةٌ وَمَا لَنَا شَرِيكٌ كَمَا افْتَرَى الْمُفْتَرُونَ عَلَىٰ عِبَادِنَا الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. We have not brought forth a son, neither did we acquire a consort, nor did we ever have a companion. Only the apostates conjecture such opinions concerning the religion of our believing worshippers. وَشَهِدَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا بِأَنَّ تَجَلَّيْنَا لَهُمْ بِمَظَاهِرَ ثَلَاثَةٍ إِلَّا أَنَّ لَنَا الْمَظَاهِرَ وَالتَّجَلِّيَاتِ جَمِيعًا. Our believing worshippers testify that we have appeared to them in manifestations demonstrating three persons. However, unto us are the phenomenal manifestations as well as the fantastic transfiguration. واتخذونا بالإيمان أبا آبا وشهدونا ابنا رحمانا وعرفونا روحا رحيما فما ظلموا أنفسهم وما كفروا ولا كانوا مشركين. Furthermore, they accepted us by faith as our Father and beheld us as the merciful Son and acknowledged us as the comforting Spirit. Therefore, they did not malign themselves, neither they blaspheme, nor did they add partners to us. فنحن الآب الكلمة الروح ثالوث فرد إله واحد لا شريك لنا في السماوات والأرضين. For we are the Father, the Son, the Spirit, as a triune God, and only one God. None is beside us in the heavens or the earth. ونحن الله الرحمن الرحيم ثالوث فرد إله واحد لا شريك لنا بالعالمين. We are the God who is most gracious, most beneficent, the only one God who has no companion in the universe. وشهد الذين آمنوا من عبادنا بأن الإله الأوحد الثالوث الموحد كنها ولا انفصام له عدا فقد صدقوا وكذب المشركون. Those who believe from among our followers publicize that we are the one and only true God, the triune in unity, united in Trinity, essentially so without separation or addition. They in fact have spoken the truth concerning us, while the impostors lied. إنما المسيح كلمة روحنا فآمنوا بنا وبكلمتنا وبروحنا فلا تقولوا ثلاثة انتهوا خيرا لكم إنما نحن إله واحد بكلمة واحدة وبروح واحدة فنحن الإله الواحد الأوحد أفلا تؤمنون. The Messiah is actually the word of our spirit. Thus believe in us, our word and our spirit. Do not say three. Cease from such deceptive pronouncements, for it is more advantageous to you. We are in fact one God with one word and one spirit. Consequently, we are the one and only true God. Why don't you accept this clear-cut revelation as the absolute truth? Quranic affirmation of Christians and their belief in monotheism. Consider with me, please, this remarkable declaration in Surah 29:46. And argue not with the people of the scripture unless it be a way that is better, save with such of them as do wrong. Most people are not aware that there is more commonality between Christianity and Islam than any other religion in the world except Judaism. From this passage, it becomes obvious that the Quran testifies that Christians are not shirkers, but truly believe in one and only true God. We further believe that this same true God has revealed himself as triune in unity, united in Trinity. It is not any Christian council's concoction or conclusion. It is rather God's revelation of himself, as we have tried to discuss, probe, and understand during this session. Another remarkable statement in Surah 582, and thou wilt find the nearest of them in affection to those who believe to be those who say, "Lo, we are Christians." That is because they are among them priests and monks, and because they are not proud. Finally, every resurrection celebration called Easter in the West, we in Nazareth take eggs, we color them, and share them with each other, because the egg represents three in one. For us, the shell represents Jesus, the visible God. The white represents the Holy Spirit, the God the Father. And we rejoice, and that's why we color it. But if you put a fresh egg under a hen for 21 days, life comes from within. And that is the representation of the resurrection. All in all, I believe with all my heart that God loves you, and that's why he came to earth, to save you and to save me. I thank you, and God bless you.
Now, Dr. Shirosh thinks that God is a three in one, and he tried to maintain that by reciting from some written passages. But reciting it again and again is not going to make it understandable. It's just repeating the same thing. He is three and yet one, and he is creator and sustainer and cherisher and nourisher and so on. And he is the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, but these three are one. The Father is God, the Son is God, the Holy Ghost is God, but these are not three gods, but one God. You can keep repeating that ad infinitum, but you have to give a reasonable explanation that will help a person to understand that. Is the egg a reasonable explanation? No, because one part of the egg, let's say the shell by itself, which he says represents Jesus, would not be the whole egg. Many of you would be disappointed if you go buy a dozen eggs and all you get are eggshells. And I don't mean to be funny, I'm just trying to, you know, make the point very clear. Now, I respect the verse of the Quran which he cited. We should not argue with the people of the book except in a way that is most gracious. And yes, the Quran does speak of Christians respectfully, even though the Quran does maintain as well that Christians, by saying certain things, they have not stuck to the original monotheism. So the Quran says, لا تكولوا ثلاثة. Now, if Dr. Shirosh were to follow that, he would just keep saying one and he wouldn't say three. Do not say three, it says. So the Quran does in fact invite them as well.